working this on
again? Keep working for me, baby.
Okay. I y'all give it up for Miss Zelle and Dominique. Yes, Lord. Give it up for Get. I know you can do better than that, y'all. Together, a legend. You are very on. What you are very on legend. This is better than that. That's right. This is like such a long time ago, the last time the first time I met her. Long time ago. It was, see? I can't be jealous of someone that I admire, who has never done me a harm a day in her life, her or her sister. Very good friends with the both of them all of my life. They actually taught me a lot of things that I've learned along my path, so I have not one good thing to say about her at all. Was it really? I did not know that. I did not know.
Now you know.
At this time, is that thing there? Would you hold that for me? At this time, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to welcome to the stage. She's doing a special dedication this evening for some of our farmers who have passed and gone away. Keep in mind Ms. Tasha Reshore, Ms. Giovanni Shell Olivier, Allegra White, I said Tasha Reshore, and of course Asia Alexander, who was not a farmer, was having that lunch, but she was on the board for years, putting the pageant on with Allegra and Opal and all of those other ladies. So at this time, welcome in her special dedication number to all of those farmers, and of course, Ms. Roslyn Heights. Welcome the talents of the very beautiful Ms. Opal.
Yes.
At this time, we are going to move on to our next phase of competition, which is our talent competition. At this time, contestant number one.
So that's good. That means there's only probably two more categories. That means there's probably only two more categories.
Okay, does he know? At this time, I'm sorry, we have one more entertainer before we get to talent. She's a former Miss Heavenly at Large 2000. Welcome the talents of the Lady Bliss. Hands together, please.
Oh,
very well, very easy. All right. Thank you. Quick announcement. I need to turn off the lights. I can't hear. We have Mr. in this exquisite 2007. Last year I missed this pageant, but I heard it was a really good pageant. And it is coming back, you all. Our theme for that evening would be superheroes and villains. No, that's good. It's August 3rd, 2007. It's going to be at the Astor Crown Plaza Hotel, 739 Canal Street, right here in New Orleans. VIP admission is $30. General admission will be $20. Showtime is at 7 p.m. And there's a mandatory registration at 2 o'clock p.m. the day of the pageant, which is August 3rd, 2007 of this year. They're giving away over $2,000 in cash. Think about that. Anywho, our categories for that, we have interview. Immediately following registration that day, we have presentation, which is red, black, or a combination of the two. Here on the thing, of course. We have sportswear, which is non-seasonal, formal wear, evening gown, your own thing. On stage, question and answer, talent will be 7 minutes with a 3-minute prop setup. We have special guest performances that evening, formerly Zelle, Opal, Vanderhurst. Welcome to the stage and keep talent competition. Welcome, competitor number one, Isha Iman Alexander. Hands together.
Beside us to fill the night with the sound. Thank you.
talent is woman. I will certainly did, but today I'm only going to wear one.
Yeah.
movie. Do we have a prop set up for our next competitor? We do not. So, judges, at this time, DJ, white man, if you are ready, we have to move along, so we're gonna get y'all to write little comments as quickly as you can, sharpen them up, you can go back and finish them out. So we keep the pageant moving right on along. So at this time, in time of competition, DJ, white man, if you are ready, welcome to the stage, competitor number 4 in time of competition, Miss Amailia, black.
Oh,
for Miss Amailia Black. Ooh. Yes, ma'am. At this time, if our next contestant has a prop set up, please do so at this time. Judges, we need you to leave your comments really quickly, and we can come back to them after the category is over and fill them in so we can keep moving so we can make up for time. Is the next contestant ready? Can I hear y'all? She ready? She is? Okay. Judges, if you are ready. Audience, if you are ready. DJ White, and if you are ready, at this time, the title competition, welcome to the stage. Female competitor number 5. This is Miss Armani Nicole Davenport.
This is a journey into music and sound. Watch out and get ready to move your feet. Wherever you are, you will be a part of it. Get ready, Armani. So get ready, Daddy.
The attack begins. Let's get to work.
Oh!
If you are ready, at this time, in time competition, welcome to the stage, your last and final competitor this evening. Put your hands together for Miss Beyonce. Black, hands together, please.
And Curtis is supposed to
love me. Curtis was supposed to love me.
There you are, Effie. I've been looking all over.
Is that possible for you to do that? It's not possible for me to do that, okay? Well, I'm gonna start as soon as someone in her entourage comes over here letting me know that she doesn't have another CD or it was your system or what. I don't wanna call her out to be absolutely sure we're gonna use that CD or if it's our system or something like that.
Oh,
now, now. I'm building this group to have you tear it apart. Go ahead and run and scream and shout. Don't worry, baby.
Dallas, Texas. sisters, put your hands together for the talents of Miss Kelexis Davenport, your current reigning and heavenly at large. Hands together, please.
DJ, he's trying so hard. It ain't his fault. Thank you so much, David. But I'm gonna go on, I think that game was a testament. I'm trying to get ready. I was trying to stall because, you know, we can't do this without those contestants. And they're trying to get ready and stuff. They've been back there stealing all year trying to get ready for the pageant and stuff. Ain't no rhinestones at Hobby Lobby, nowhere in Louisiana, so we're gonna move on and let the next girl come out. And who is it? Oh shit, this is my girlfriend. We was back there starting a fight a while ago, because it's a Mexican man back there washing dishes. And we was trying to see which one of us was gonna rob him. Yeah, but like this time, ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together and welcome to the stage with a thunderous round of applause. She was Miss Heavenly at Large in 2000, and she's no one other than your very own, the Lady Bliss.
Baby, will you roll? Sun and rain and heavy snow. Come to me, it's all gonna be. Will you love me?
Lynn, Fox, hands together, please.
Thank you. Again, thank you for your support. We do appreciate it. But we wanted to do this is just on a whim of a surprise. But I think she kind of knows what's happening, but trying to play still surprise. So, Terry Fox, this is your life.
Oh, all right, girl.
This is our first, guys, legendary award in honor of Allegra White, legendary award. And we want to thank the first recipient that received it. And who better came to mind than a girl who has really put a mark in history on New Orleans. I've known her for a very long time. Very long time. I watched her develop, grow from the terror that was on Esplanade in the morning going to school to now becoming just fabulous, elegant, wonderful woman. And what we thought would represent that in the best words possible would be crystal, because it just represents fine. I don't know what other words to say, but just elegant. You hear? Perfect. Perfect. And Jodesh, it's kind of heavy, Miss T. Fox, girl. But something is holding.
You can put your gladiolus in there.
You can sit in that, Terry. It's very elegant. Is it crystal for you? That's the award that Allegra White, first legendary award. I think I speak for everyone in this room.
Speak, girl, speak.
Hold on, not only that, I have to get a refined wine. You want to savor the flavor, but still have the essence of it. We bought some lovely perfume by Bulgaria as well. So you can spray a little bit every now and then and say, I'm a legend now. So speak, sir.
All right.
You know, this is truly a surprise to me, and I would like to thank the sponsors and the promoters of Miss Heavenly at Large. I've been with this system for many, many years. And in my career, I've received many awards and won many competitions, but something like this is very special to me because it shows me the love that I feel for my sisters in the city of New Orleans. I love each and every one of you, and I support you in everything that you do. And anytime you need a friend, just call me. It's not before 9 o'clock in the morning.
Thank you, everybody.
They don't have another downstairs. clouds.
This is where we need a moment of silence because this is a very hard part of the pageant. And I know some of you may go up for some of the things she said, but something you should know that they need all quality. Okay, Yesha, I'm going to read the question to you once, then I'm going to let you read it, and after that, we'll have your answer. The heavily at-large pageantry system has been around for 15 years. For the last 5 years, we have considered ourselves to be a national competition. This year, we are seeking national corporate sponsorship. How would you go about getting them to sponsor this pageant, and what would you tell them about us? Thank you. System has been around for 15 years. For the last 5 years, we've considered ourselves to be a national competition. How would you go about achieving sponsorship for this pageant, and what would you tell them about us? Ladies and gentlemen, in Q&A competition, contestant number one, Yesha Alexander. Thank you.
Thank you. Well, how would I go about getting sponsorship for this pageant, being considering that it is a national pageant for the past 5 years? Well, I am not like a lot of other girls who compete in this pageant. I am not a 5 or 6 time national title holder. I've only been doing this for a little while. And in the short time that I have been preparing for this pageant, I have learned a lot. I have to work 3 and 4 times as hard as most of the other girls here just to get the same respect that these national title holders deserve, that they get. So with that experience, I would be able to make them understand that is what this pageant means to me. It means that this is a national pageantry system in New Orleans, Louisiana. Everyone from New Orleans or anywhere else who means anything to anybody, everybody will look up to as far as this pageant goes or a part of this pageant. And I will also let them know that...
Take your time.
I will also let them know as far as sponsoring this pageant, that we are a wonderful system, and the system means everything to me. And I can't explain how it makes them understand what the system means to me, and how it makes them understand that I deserve to get the same respect that the other girls deserve.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. That is your contestant number one, Rachel Alexander.
Thank you.
job that she's going to do for you, Octavia. How are you feeling today? Fabulous, wonderful. He's going to repeat the question to you twice, let you read it for yourself, and then give you a lot of time so that she can respond. Okay? Good luck.
Hey, how you doing? You look wonderful. The Heavenly Alert Tragic Truth System has been around for 15 years. For the last 5 years, we've considered ourselves to be a national competition. This year, we are seeking national and corporate sponsorship. What would you tell them about us? The Heavenly at Large Tragic Truth System has been around 15 years. For the last 5 years, we have considered ourselves to be a national competition. What would you tell them about us, and how would you go about getting the sponsorship?
What I would do to promote and tell people about the pageant is simply what it is, that it's a great system and been around for 15 years, and like they say, have been national for 5. But of course, me being an entertainer in the straight club as well as the gay club, I will promote this system. Thank you.
Me to all of you, I want to say thank you very much.
in response to the question. In response to the question, with heavily at large being 15, 16 years old, I don't want to speak down. I'm going to speak my mind and speak from my heart. This is the first time I've ever heard of this system.
All right.
And that's not good. I work for MAC. I do makeup for MAC. So the easiest thing you can do to get corporate sponsors is for whoever is your next queen. She has to be dedicated.
All right.
And this has to be a passion for her. I live my life every day. I am 41 years old. I've been in business for 20 years. I live my life every day reinventing myself. Because there is a transsexual showgirl born every second. So you have to be on point. All it takes is for someone to be professional, a class act, such as myself, and dedicated to her craft, and get the word out there.
And you're ready.
Thank you very much. I'm the second one for you, Dr. Christian.
Sponsorship for us, and what would you tell them about us? The Heavenly at Large pageantry system has been around for 15 years. For the last 5 years, we have considered ourselves to be a national competition. How would you go about getting this sponsorship for us, and what would you tell them about us?
Good evening, ladies, gentlemen, and judges. I'm finalist number 4, Amailia Black. In response to the question, how would I go about getting national sponsorship for this pageant? It's very simple. I would sit down with all of the promoters and owners of Heavenly at Large, and we would put together an outstanding promotional package to show to all the vendors we are interested in using on a national level. That way, we can get all the sponsorship that we need for this pageant to grow for the next 15 years.
Yeah.
Ladies, gentlemen, and judges, in question and answer, I'm finalist number 4.
Thank you. absolutely just the same. It is now time for our next competitor in keeping out this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together. Volume, please. The times. A female competitor number 5, Armani, Nicole, Davenport. Volume, please. Volume. Her job designer is the model herself and Little Ugly Promotions. Her beautiful lavender,
considered ourselves to be a national competition. This year the pageant is seeking corporate sponsorship. How would you go about getting this for us, and what would you tell them about us? The Heavenly and Large Pageantry System has been around for 15 years. For the past 5 years, we've considered ourselves to be a national competition. This year we're seeking corporate sponsorship. How would you go about getting this for us, and what would you tell them about us? Armani.
Thank you. Well, for those of you who don't know me, I am Armani Nicole Davenport, a former Miss Black America Plus. Right. Now, being Miss Black America Plus, I had no prelims, so I was out there searching. And I thought I had ran into an incomplete section in my life that I wasn't doing something right.
All right.
So when I gave up Black America, guess what? I had 5 prelims. So at that point in time, I knew by me going out just entertaining and being a people's person, and being able for someone to come up to me and say, well, I'm thinking about considering doing drag, but I don't really know what to do. And just listen to whatever they may have to say. And sometimes you may think whatever the person has to say may not really mean much to them, but actually it does. Because they take whatever you say and then they strive for it. So then by you being a people person, they pretend to listen and then they grasp onto what you're saying. And then you don't know that you actually educated and enlightened them.
All right.
So what I would do is just go out, advertise and promote and enlighten them. And then take someone's hand and say, I think you'll be the next Miss Heavenly at Large. Thank you.
Thank you, Armani. Judges, again, please make your quick rotation and you can go back later for your complete comments. We have the competition right online. And at this time, welcome to the stage, our last and final competitor of this evening. An evening out competition, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the stage. Competitor number 6, and her name is Beyonce Monique Black. Beyonce, a black person.
how you know he looks stunning. Okay, I'm going to read this to you twice, and then I'll let you answer. The Heavenly LR Tracture System has been around for 15 years. For the very last 5 years, we've considered ourselves to be a national competition. This year, we're seeking corporate sponsorship. How would you go about getting this for us, and what would you tell them about us? The Heavenly LR Tracture System has been around for 15 years. For the last 5 years, we've considered ourselves to be a national competition. This year, we're seeking corporate sponsorship. How would you go about getting this for us, and what would you tell them about us?
After she answers this question, I'm going to go check on the truck.
I would have to say that I would tell corporations this is something that you need to support because it's a gay function. We need to support our gay peers out in the straight world. I'm a working girl, meaning not on the streets, but a working girl in the world. I work for a photography company as I am. They support me, so meaning they would actually support us in the gay world. With this passion, I'll let them know that we have lovely farmers, and they will see the passion to see how well that our gay society is, that we are functioning people. And we do need this kind of function to continue to show you, the straight peers, as well as the gay people, that we can be united and be one. Thank you.
Thank you, Beyonce.
Ladies and gentlemen and judges, let us conclude the competition for this evening. Thank you, contestant number 6, Beyonce of Black. DJ, if you are ready, we have one entertainer before our comedy number, and we will find out who's our next is heavily at large. But in the meantime, at this time, New Orleans, Louisiana, please welcome to the stage in their very first duet together as your current reigning Mr. and Miss New Orleans newcomer. Welcome Miss Shiny Star and Mr. Scion Manning. Hands together, please.
Sorry about that.
Come at your change.
That's the best
dollar you've been
for you. I
bet you
sing it all.
Yeah,
sing it too.
Right. I love those kinds. really good shades. Alright, sorry about that, you guys. Sorry about that. But we're going to keep the show from around along. Ladies and gentlemen, one of Louisiana, please welcome to the stage in her final walk today. Welcome. She's professional, she's ready, trust me. Your current rating, Miss Heavenly at large. She goes by the title today on Miss Kelexis Davenport in her final walk this evening. New Orleans, come on, let's get off with Miss Kelexis Davenport giving up her title this evening. Miss Heavenly at large. After she finished speaking, just started, okay? Next film. How's everybody doing in here?
Good.
I won't hold you long. I just have a few things that I would like to say. This is a very special moment to me, that I would just like to publicly acknowledge a few people. As a young boy, trying to find my place in the world, long before the birth of the artist we know today, as Kelexis Davenport, I came to New Orleans with Tommy Ross and Nicki DeAndre to escape the normalities of my day-to-day life, never knowing that that trip would be a pivotal part of becoming the person that I am today. As we drove into the Ivory Bell Projects, I met a young man who I just called Miss Chad. To everyone else, this entertainer was the legendary, late great, Khalid Valentino. I had never been so amazed by anyone's presence as I was to hear. Later that same evening, I went to a legendary landmark
here in New Orleans,
known as Whoopingdale's, where I had the pleasure to make the acquaintance of the stunning Epiphany Cartier, Tasha Sean, Allegra White, and Asia Alexander. Although these young ladies have gone on to their glory, they changed my life. Because of them, I am who I am today. After that first trip and meeting all those beautiful individuals, I knew that I was destined to be a star. From that point on, I started to jump on every stunt ticket I could to fly straight to New Orleans to be on the Monday Night Show at Club Rumble. Never one time did they buy a paycheck. I then met the lovely Paris Frank, who opened her home and her heart to me. She took me to get my first hot sausage sandwich at Jimmy's Homeboy. And I made my first piece of New Orleans shreddy at the Brewster Project. To me, those were times that I would never, ever get back and I will always cherish. I'm sure you're saying, what does this have to do with now? And my answer is simply, New Orleans has always been a second home to me. With its contrast and its diversity, this place has shaped me into and what I am today. So to Tara Lynn Fox, Tova Lay, Ms. Bam, Simone, Tierra Dominique, and Opal Vanderhurst, thank you, ladies, for taking me into your lives and allowing me to always stay true to myself. Good, bad, or indifferent, I am your sister, and I love you. I am humbled to be a part of the elite, heavenly, and large family. This reign has special memories for me, and I'd like to publicly acknowledge the wonderful collaboration of dedicated people who helped me to achieve it. To Orlando Russell, Armani Davenport, Ben Early, Kayla Davenport, Dominic Sanchez, Amber Stevens, Kyron Davenport, Madison Claire, Brandon the First Lady Stewart, Irving Williams, and Layla LaRue, and DeMonica Jackson, because of you, I am able to shine. I would just be a mere nigga of light without you. And last but not least, the wind beneath my wings, my lover, my friend, my little ugly, Chris Brzee. You are the strength behind Kelexis Davenport. You are so loyal, so true. I can't thank you enough for all that you do and all that you give. No one else can love me the way you do. I'm blessed to have such a wonderful and full life.
I'm thankful to God for my strength and my serenity, and I'm thankful to you, the patrons of this art form, who through every test of time has been there for me, and I thank you, and I love you, and I am Miss Heavenly at Large, Kelexis Davenport.
Thank you.
feedback on the contestants.
Armani Davenport.
Swimwear.
Armani.
Put swimwear step forward, please.
Armani.
Swimwear.
Armani.
Oh, More money, more problems. Well, I don't see no cash standing here.
Right here.
Oh, okay. All right, swimwear goes to Armani Davenport.
Congratulations to Armani Nicole Davenport on her grand national celebrity. And good night, y'all. See you next year.